Hello everyone, our subject is microeconomics. So we have already completed unit number 2, that is demand, supply and elasticity of demand, in which we have to prepare various questions, that is factor affecting demand, low of demand, factor affecting supply, low of supply, here types of elasticity, factor affecting elasticity. So today we are going to start about our unit number 1, that is definition of economics. So let's start with the very first unit, that is definition of economics, in which you have to prepare 3 definitions you already learned in 11 or 12 standard, that is wealth definition, welfare definition, scarcity definition, and there are nature and scope of the economics, and last question, the concept of economic activity and non-economic activity. Clear? So let's start with the very first one, that is the meaning of economics. So what do you mean by economics? Generally in economics there are 2 type of activity, generally in economics, clear, only consider the economical activity. First, there are 2 type of activity, economic activity and non-economic activity. Clear? Economic activity means the main objective of earning a maximum profit. Clear? And non-economic activity means generally provide social welfare activity, free of education, free of healthcare, medical care facility. Clear? So here is free of transportation. આ બધાને કેવી કહેવાશે? નોન ઇકોનોમિક એક્ટિવિટી. મેઇન ઓબ્જેક્ટિવ ઇઝ સોશિયલ વેલફેર, સોશિયલ બેનિફિટ. ક્લિયર? બટ ઇકોનોમિક્સ ઓનલી કન્સિડર ધી ઇકોનોમિકલ એક્ટિવિટી, મની રિલેટેડ એક્ટિવિટી. મેઇન ઓબ્જેક્ટિવ ઇઝ અર્નિંગ ઇન્કમ, અર્નિંગ મેક્સિમમ પ્રોફિટ. ક્લિયર? સો મટીરિયાલિસ્ટિક એક્ટિવિટી એન્ડ નોન મટીરિયાલિસ્ટિક એક્ટિવિટી. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, એક્ઝામ્પલ ઇઝ when doctor provide treatment to their own son, clear, daughter, it will be considered as a non-economical activity. But when doctor provide treatments to their patients, clear, then it will be considered as an economical activity, because main objective is earning a income, earning a money. Clear? So economics, one thing you have to keep in mind, economics only consider the economical activity or money related activity, finance related activity. Clear? So first one, economics, here is, let's start with the very first one, that is meaning of economics. Clear? Meaning of economics. So here is, economics is defined as the study of how human works together to convert limited resource into goods and service to satisfy their needs and wants, which are always unlimited. Clear? So here is one thing you have to keep in mind, each and every human being have a unlimited needs and wants, but the resources are limited. Clear? For example, once you satisfy your one need, then immediately second need is arise. Clear? For example, once you purchase bicycle, then your next need is to purchase two wheel. Once you purchase two wheel, then your next need is to purchase car. Clear? Once you purchase a simple car, then your next need is luxurious car. Clear? So your needs and wants are always unlimited, but the resources, clear, land, labor, capital, always is limited. Clear? So here is the main objective of human being. Clear? The main objective of each and every human being is to satisfy their needs and wants with the help of limited resources. Resources are limited. Listen, તમારી પાસે મની કેવા હોય? મની ઇઝ કન્સિડર એઝ અ રિસોર્સિસ. લેબર, ક્લિયર, વર્કર્સ આર કન્સિડર એઝ અ રિસોર્સિસ ફોર ધી ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન. કેપિટલ, મની, ફાઇનાન્સ ઇઝ કન્સિડર એઝ અ રિસોર્સિસ. સો યુ હેવ ઓલવેઝ લિમિટેડ રિસોર્સિસ, સો દેર શુડ બી અલ્ટરનેટિવ યુઝ. ક્લિયર? સો ધેન યુ હેવ ટુ ડિસાઇડ ધી અર્જન્સી, ઇમ્પોર્ટન્સ ઓફ યોર નીડ્સ. જનરલી દેર આર 2 ટાઈપ્સ ઓફ નીડ્સ, primary needs and secondary needs. Primary needs means basic necessities of life, food, shelter and cloth. Clear? So first you have to satisfy your basic necessity. Then you have to satisfy your secondary needs, luxurious needs. Clear? So here is, so you have to decide priority. Which need is most important and which need is least important. Clear? So you have to decide the priority. You have to decide that which type of needs and wants is more important to satisfy first. Clear? So how they distribute the same among themselves. Economic has been divided into two broad parts, that is microeconomics and macroeconomics. So there are two types of economics. Here is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Clear? Microeconomics is study the individual form and individual firm's problem. Clear? Individual firm or individual business, particular business which affect, for example, if there will be a strike, clear, then it will be affected only one firm. For example, if there will be a strike, lockout of the, for example, a particular company, then it will be affected only one firm. Clear? Koi pan company ma strike thai ke wages issue hoy, bonus issue hoy, clear? A kone affect karse? Only ek j company ne, ek j organization. Clear? To ene kevo problem kevo ase? Micro problem. So it is, it will be included in microeconomics. Clear? Macroeconomics means wide. For example, if there will be a change in GDP, if there will be a change in poverty ratio, clear? Poverty problem, unemployment situation, clear? Gross domestic product, clear? Then population. Abadha keva problem chhe? Population explosion, clear? Vasti visfot. Abadha keva problem chhe? Macro problem. If there will be a change in GDP, then it affects the whole country. Clear? If there will be a change in national income, then it affect the whole country. Je ekaj company ne affect kare ne micro problem kevay, ane je akha India ne affect kare ne kevo kevay macro problem. Clear? For example, in particular company there will be a wages issue, salary issue, to ekone affect karse only one company, so it will be considered as a micro problem. Clear? Macro means, for example, GDP ma change aave, national income ma change aave, per capita income ma change aave. Clear? To akone affect karse whole India. Clear? Which affect the whole India, so it will be considered as a macro problem. So let's start with the very first, that is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics, in which you have to decide the demand, supply, elasticity. Clear? So here is, in semester 1 you have to study only microeconomics and semester 2 you have to study macroeconomics. So micro means here is considered related with the individual's firm problem. Clear? Household. So here is microeconomics is the study of economic behavior of particular individual firm or household, or you can say particular unit. On other end, macroeconomics is the study of economy as a whole, not single unit, but the combination of all firms, household, or can you can say nation, country. Clear? So generally, koi par problem hoi, ek aj company ne ke ek aj organization ne affect kare ne ke wo problem ke waase micro problem. Have je kai problem hoi, akha country ne affect kare ne ke wo ke waase macro. So macro is more wider, clear, and micro means narrow. So it is microeconomics and macro. So micro means the branch of economics that analyze the market behavior of individual consumer and firms in attempt to understand and understand the decision making process of the firms and households. So it is concerned with the concern means related with the interaction between individual buyer and seller and the factors that influence the choice made by the buyer and seller. So microeconomics means here is the analyze the behavior. Clear? Here is analyze the market behavior of individual customer, market behavior of individual customer, or you can say individual firm problem. For example, if there will be a demand for the tea in the market, then demand situation, supply situation, it affect the particular firm or particular company. Clear? Then for example, here is wages problem, salary problem, strike by the employees. Clear? Sometimes there are so many demand. Clear? So many demand from the side of employees. Clear? Sometimes salary increment, bonus. Clear? Bonus problem. આ બધા જે સેલરી ઇસ્યુ છે, વેજીસ પ્રોબ્લેમ છે, આ કોને અફેક્ટ કરે? સિંગલ કંપની ઓર સિંગલ ફર્મ, વિથ નોટ અફેક્ટ ધી હોલ કન્ટ્રી. ક્લિયર? સો હિયર ઇઝ માઇક્રો મીન્સ ધ એનાલાઇઝ ઓફ ધી માર્કેટ બિહેવિયર ઓફ ધી પર્ટિક્યુલર કંપની ઓર ઇન્ડિવિજ્યુઅલ કંપની. ક્લિયર? સો ઇટ અફેક્ટ ધી ઓનલી વન કંપની. ક્લિયર? કોઈ પણ પ્રોબ્લેમ હોય, સેલરી પ્રોબ્લેમ, વેજીસ પ્રોબ્લેમ, વર્કિંગ એન્વાયરમેન્ટ પ્રોબ્લેમ. ક્લિયર? સો ઇટ અફેક્ટ ધી ઓનલી વન કંપની. ક્લિયર? નોટ હોલ કન્ટ્રી. ક્લિયર? સો ઇટ ઇઝ મેક્રો ઇકોનોમિક્સ, ધેન માઇક્રો એન્ડ મેક્રો. મેક્રો મીન્સ વિચ અફેક્ટ ધી હોલ કન્ટ્રી. હવે જો માઇક્રો ઇકોનોમિક્સ એટલે કે કોઈ પણ પ્રોબ્લેમ હોય, એ એક જ કંપની કે એક જ ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશનને અફેક્ટ કરશે. ક્લિયર? Then macro means which affect the whole country. આખા ઇન્ડિયાને અફેક્ટ કરશે. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, ઇફ ધર વિલ બી અ ચેન્જ ઇન જીડીપી, જીડીપીમાં ચેન્જ આવે તો એ કોને અફેક્ટ કરશે? હોલ કન્ટ્રી. ક્લિયર? ધેન ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, નેશનલ ઇન્કમ, રાષ્ટ્રીય આવક, નેશનલ ઇન્કમમાં ચેન્જ આવે તો એ કોને અફેક્ટ કરશે? હોલ કન્ટ્રી. સો ઇટ વિલ બી કન્સિડર એઝ અ મેક્રો. મેક્રો મીન્સ વાઇડ, વિચ અફેક્ટ ધી હોલ ઇન્ડિયા. ક્લિયર? So the field of economics that study the behavior of aggregate economy. Aggregate economy means overall economy of India. Koi par problem hase, like GDP problem, national income, per capita income, unemployment, poverty. Clear? Then population explosion, then international trade, internal trade. Clear? Export, import. A badha keva problem che? Macro problem. તો આમાં કંઈ પણ ચેન્જ આવે, ધેટ અફેક્ટ ધી એગ્રીગેટ ઇકોનોમી. એગ્રીગેટ ઇકોનોમી મીન્સ ઓવરઓલ ઇન્ડિયા. ક્લિયર? મેક્રો ઇકોનોમિક્સ એક્ઝામિન ધ ઇકોનોમી વાઇડ ફિનોમિના સચ એઝ ચેન્જ ઇન અનએમ્પ્લોયમેન્ટ, નેશનલ ઇન્કમ. ક્લિયર? ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, હિયર ઇઝ લાઈક અ ચેન્જ ઇન અનએમ્પ્લોયમેંટ. અનએમ્પ્લોયમેન્ટ મીન્સ બેરોજગારી. ક્લિયર? પર્સન હેવ અ વિલિંગનેસ ટુ ડુ ધી જોબ, બટ ધે ડીડન્ટ ફાઇન્ડ ધી આઈડિયલ જોબ. અનએમ્પ્લોયમેન્ટનો મિનિંગ શું થશે? બેરોજગારી, કે પર્સનને જોબ કરવી હોય. ક્લિયર? બટ ધે ડીડન્ટ ફાઇન્ડ ધી આઈડિયલ જોબ, બેસ્ટ જોબ. નેશનલ ઇન્કમ. ક્લિયર? રાષ્ટ્રીય આવક, રેટ ઓફ ગ્રોથ, ડોમેસ્ટિક જીડીપી, ગ્રોસ ડોમેસ્ટિક પ્રોડક્ટ. વોટ ડુ યુ મીન બાય જીડીપી? જીડીપી મીન્સ ધ ઇન્કમ, ઓર યુ કેન સે રેવન્યુ રિસીવ ફ્રોમ ધી ગુડ્સ એન્ડ સર્વિસ વિચ ઇઝ પ્રોડ્યુસ વિધિન ધી કન્ટ્રી. ધેન ઇન્ફ્લેશન. ઇન્ફ્લેશન મીન્સ કન્ટિન્યુઅસલી ઇન્ક્રીઝિંગ પ્રાઇસ લેવલ. ઇન્ફ્લેશન મીન્સ ભાવ વધારો, ફુગાવો. ક્લિયર? વેન પ્રાઇસ ઓફ ધી પ્રોડક્ટ કન્ટિન્યુઅસલી ઇન્ક્રીઝ, ઇટ વિલ બી કન્સિડર એઝ અ ઇન્ફ્લેશનરી સિચ્યુએશન. વોટ વિલ બી ધ exactly happening inflationary situation? The price of product continuously increase. Clear? But your income will not continuously increase, so your purchasing power will be reduced during the inflationary situation, because you have to pay more money to purchase the less number of item. Clear? Market ma jyare inflation chalto hoy, bhav vadharo chalto hoy, clear, tyare tamare પ્રાઇસ કેવી પે કરવી પડે? વધુ, ટુ પરચેઝ લેસર નંબર ઓફ આઇટમ. સો યુ હેવ ટુ પે મોર પ્રાઇસ ઓફ ધી પ્રોડક્ટ ડ્યુરિંગ ઇન્ફ્લેશનરી સિચ્યુએશન. સો મેક્રો, જસ્ટ યુ હેવ ટુ કીપ ઇન માઇન્ડ. માઇક્રો ઇકોનોમિક્સ મીન્સ કોઈ પણ પ્રોબ્લેમ હશે, લાઈક વેજીસ ઇન્ક્રીમેન્ટ, વર્કિંગ એન્વાયરમેન્ટ, ધેન હિયર ઇઝ સ્ટ્રાઇક ઓફ ધી એમ્પ્લોઈઝ. ક્લિયર? ધેર વિલ બી અ કન્ફ્લિક્ટ બિટવીન એમ્પ્લોયર એન્ડ એમ્પ્લોઈઝ. કોઈ ડિસ્પ્યુટ કે ઝઘડો થાય એમ્પ્લોયર ને એમ્પ્લોય વચ્ચે. ક્લિયર? તો આ જે પ્રોબ્લેમ છે, ધેટ શુડ બી અફેક્ટ ઓનલી વન કંપની, નોટ હોલ કન્ટ્રી. ક્લિયર? એન્ડ મેક્રો મીન્સ વાઇડ, કે કોઈ પણ જીડીપીમાં ચેન્જ આવે, નેશનલ ઇન્કમમાં ચેન્જ આવે, પર કેપિટા ઇન્કમમાં ચેન્જ આવે, ઇન્ફ્લેશનરી સિચ્યુએશન આવે કન્ટ્રીમાં, તો આ બધું કોને અફેક્ટ કરશે? હોલ ઇન્ડિયા, નોટ પર્ટિક્યુલર કંપની. ક્લિયર? આખા ઇન્ડિયાને અફેક્ટ કરશે. સો મેક્રો ઇકોનોમિક્સ ડિટરમાઇન ધી નેશનલ ઇન્કમ ઓફ કન્ટ્રી. બજેટ ડેફિસિટ. ક્લિયર? બજેટ ડેફિસિટ મીન્સ સરપ્લસ બેલેન્સ એન્ડ ડેફિસિટ. સરપ્લસ મીન્સ યોર ઇન્કમ ઇઝ હાયર ધેન યોર એક્સપેન્સ, એન્ડ ડેફિસિટ એટલે નેગેટિવ. યોર એક્સપેન્સ, કન્ટ્રીઝ એક્સપેન્સ ઇઝ હાયર એઝ કમ્પેર્ડ ટુ ઇન્કમ. ક્લિયર? સો હિયર ઇઝ ઇકોનોમિક્સ ઇઝ ધ સાયન્સ ધેટ ડીલ્સ વિથ પ્રોડક્શન, એક્સચેન્જ એન્ડ કન્ઝપ્શન. સો જનરલી ઇકોનોમિક્સ ઇઝ અ સાયન્સ. Clear? Theoretical. Listen, economics is in science and economics is an art. One thing you have to keep in mind, economics is science and economics as an art. Science means theoretical knowledge with proof. Clear? So here is economics is a considered as a theoretical subject and economics as an art. Art itle practical knowledge. Science means theoretical. There should be various rules, regulation, terms and conditions, clear. And art means practical knowledge. For example, various economics theories, various economics principles, you can apply in real life also. Clear? For example, demand theory, supply theory. Clear? So that type of theory, you can apply in practical life, real life. In that sense, economics is considered as an art. Abadu already tamare 11th standard ma avigyu chhe. Clear? The economics as an science, economics as an art. Clear? So it is deals with production, exchange and consumption. So production means to convert raw material into finished goods. Clear? To increase the utility of the product. Production no meaning so thase. Okay. Generally, for example, buyer and seller. So buyer have a main objective to satisfy their needs and wants. One thing you have to keep in mind. Needs and wants are unlimited, but the resources are limited. Clear? So you have to decide the priority. You have to decide your urgency of needs. Which need is most important and which need is least important. First, you have to satisfy your basic needs, that is necessities of life. Production. So production, why there should be requirement of production? To satisfy needs and wants. Consumer, there is an exchange activity. Clear? There is an exchange activity between production and consumption. So production means why seller start production activity, why manufacturer start production activity, because their main objective is earning a maximum profit. Economic activity. Economics only consider the economic activity. Clear? Then here is production means to convert raw material into finished good, or you can say in another way, you can say to increase the utility of the product. Utility means usefulness. For example, trees in the jungle have a less utility. Clear? But once you convert wooden tree into like a wooden table, chair, clear? Then utility can be increased. So only, for example, mark jungle ma je wooden hoy, trees have a less utility. But once you convert tree, clear, wooden into furniture, table, then it possesses the more utility. Clear? To increase the usefulness, to exchange activity between buyer and seller. Buyer have a main objective to satisfy their needs and wants, and seller have a main objective to earning the income. Clear? Then consumption. Consumption means to use the product. Consumption no meaning sutha se, to use the product. So generally you have to consume various product, use of the various product to satisfy your needs and wants. So there is an exchange activity taken place between buyer and seller. Clear? Generally production is done by the manufacturer and consumption is done by the consumer. So there is an exchange activity taken place between producer and consumer. Clear? Of various commodity in economic system, if so, how scarce resource can be used in increase? What do you mean by here is scarce resources? Scarce resources no meaning scarce atle shu thase limited. Scarce no meaning shu thai limited. Jo tamari needs ane wants keva chhe unlimited. Once you satisfy your one need, then immediately second need is arise. Clear? You cannot satisfy your all type of needs and wants at a one time. Clear? You have to decide your priority because resources are limited. Clear? Needs and wants are unlimited. Tamari ichhao kevi chhe? Unlimited. But tamari paase money keva chhe? Resources keva chhe? Limited. Clear? So economics suggests that how you can use limited resource. Clear? How you can satisfy your unlimited needs and wants with the help of limited resource. Tame tamara unlimited je needs and wants che, e tame kevi ritna satisfy kari sako with the help of limited financial resource. Clear? Limited human resource can be used to increase wealth and human welfare. The central focus of the economics is on scarcity of resource. Again, scarcity of resources. Clear? So here is resources are limited, scarcity means limited resources, human resource, capital resource, financial resource, clear, a badha resource keva chhe limited. Tamari, for example, if you have unlimited money, then there should be no any kind of economic problem. Clear? Badha economic problem chhe isena lide chhe ke you have a limited money, limited capital resource or limited financial resource. Tamari paase unlimited money hot, clear? Then you, there should be no any kind of problem of unemployment, there should be no any kind of problem of poverty, clear? There should be no any kind of per capita income, lower per capita income, lower national income, GDP problem, if you have an unlimited abundance money, clear? Badha problems ene lide chhe ke to you have a limited resource, limited money, tamari paase limited money chhe, clear? You have a limited resources, but needs and wants are unlimited. So economics suggests that how human being can satisfy their unlimited needs and wants with the help of limited resources. Clear? So scarcity means limited resource, limited money. So if you have a limited money, so you have two choice among their alternative use. How you can use alternative? Alternative use means more than one. Clear? For example, water. So water is considered as a natural resource and limited resource. Clear? For example, water can be used for drinking purpose, cooking purpose, industrial purpose. Clear? Then same way, land. For example, if you have a land, so land is limited. Clear? You have a limited land. So either you can, there should be so many alternative, at least more than one use. Land can be used for construction purpose. Land can be used for farming purpose. You can use for example, building tuition classes, hotels, clear, then garden. So there should be alternative, more than one use, clear. The resources and inputs available to produce goods are limited. Whatever resource inputs are available, that always in limited nature, clear, limited or scarce. Scarce no meaning so tha se achat. Scarcity means achat, limited, clear. This scarcity induces people to make choice among the alternative. If you have land, land can be used for, for example, if you have a piece of land, then either you can use for the school building, hostel building, restaurant, clear, farmhouse, then park, so farming purpose, clear, cultivation purpose. So you have to making choice. Alternative means more than one use, clear. You have to select the best option, and other option you have to forgo or sacrifice. For example, if you have a piece of land, you have to keep in mind, for example, if you have a piece of land, tamari paase jamin chhe, e kevi chhe, limited. Ave ena ghana badha alternative use chhe. Tamari paase jamin hoy to tame ema school building banavi sako, restaurant banavi sako, clear? Jamin upar tame cultivation, kheti pan kari sako, clear? So you have there are so many use, alternative options, clear, available in front of you, but you have to select the best option, clear, and other option you have to forgo or sacrifice. Tamari paase, for example, after completion of 12 commerce, you have so many options like BBA, BCA, BCom. Once you select the BBA, other option like BCA, BCom, you have to forgo or sacrifice. Clear? The next best alternative you have to forgo or sacrifice, that will be considered as your opportunity cost. Clear? Tamari paase land hoy to tamari paase ghana badha option chhe income mate na. Tame ema housing, clear? Tame, for example, kheti kari sako, cultivation, clear? Then you can make building, restaurant, clear. Then you can start school, clear. But you have to select the best option. The knowledge of economics is used to compare the alternative for choosing the best among them. So once you have a limited resource, clear, then you have to select the best option. For example, farmer can grow paddy, sugarcane, banana, cotton. Tamari paase, for example, piece of land hoy, clear, to tame ema, for example, restaurant pan banavi sako, school building pan banavi sako, clear. Then cultivation means you can cultivate clear. You can grow paddy, sugarcane, banana, cotton in his garden land, but he has to choose crop depending upon the availability of irrigation facility. For example, કોઈ પણ ફાર્મર હોય એની પાસે લેન્ડ હોય ક્લિયર તો એ લેન્ડમાં ઘણું બધું વાવી શકે ને ક્લિયર ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ પેડી સુગર કેન ધેન બનાના કોટન કલ્ટિવેશન કરી શકે આ બધા પણ વિચ ક્રોપ યુ હેવ ટુ ચૂઝ ક્લિયર ધેટ શુડ બી ઓલવેઝ ડિપેન્ડ ઓન ઇરિગેશન ફેસિલિટી ઇરિગેશન એટલે સિંચાઈ પદ્ધતિ તમારા ફાર્મમાં કેટલું વોટર અવેલેબલ છે ક્લિયર એ પ્રમાણે અકોર્ડિંગ ટુ યુ હેવ ટુ સિલેક્ટ ધી ક્રોપ ક્લિયર ટુ મેજર ફેક્ટર રિસ્પોન્સિબલ ઓફ ઇમર્જન્સ ઓફ ઇકોનોમિક પ્રોબ્લેમ ક્લિયર વાય ધેર શુડ બી ઇકોનોમિક પ્રોબ્લેમ જનરલી ઇકોનોમિક પ્રોબ્લેમ શા માટે છે સો વન્સ યુ હેવ ટુ કીપ ઇન માઇન્ડ વાય ધેર શુડ બી ઇકોનોમિક પ્રોબ્લેમ બીકોઝ ધ નીડ્સ એન્ડ વોન્ટ્સ આર અનલિમિટેડ બટ ધ રિસોર્સિસ આર limited so once you have to one thing you have to keep in mind why there should be economic problem tumne badhane for example why there should be problem of poverty why there should be problem of unemployment why there should be problem of inflationary situation clear because your income is limited ave tamari for example tamari paase unlimited money hoy unlimited income hoy to market ma gamme etlo bhav vadhe tamne kai problem aave no ઇન્ફ્લેશન થી પ્રોબ્લેમ કેમ આવે છે વાય ધેર શુડ બી પ્રોબ્લેમ ક્લિયર ડ્યુ ટુ ઇન્ફ્લેશનરી સિચ્યુએશન બીકોઝ યુ હેવ અ લિમિટેડ ઇન્કમ ક્લિયર બટ ધ નીડ્સ એન્ડ વોન્ટ્સ આર અનલિમિટેડ સો ધ એક્ઝિસ્ટન્સ ઓફ ધી અનલિમિટેડ હ્યુમન વોન્ટ્સ એન્ડ નીડ એન્ડ સેકન્ડ વન સ્કેરસિટી ઓફ અવેલેબલ રિસોર્સ સ્કેરસિટી એટલે અછત લિમિટેડ ક્લિયર એક તો રિસોર્સિસ બધા કેવા છે લિમિટેડ અને તમારા નીડ્સ અને વોન્ટ્સ ઈચ્છાઓ બધી કેવી છે અનલિમિટેડ સો ધેર શુડ બી ઇકોનોમિક પ્રોબ્લેમ ક્લિયર ધ ન્યુમરસ હ્યુમન વોન્ટ્સ આર ટુ બી સેટિસ્ફાઈડ સો ધ ન્યુમરસ વોન્ટ્સ આર ટુ બી સેટિસ્ફાઈડ થ્રુ ધ સ્કેર રિસોર્સ અવેલેબલ ઇન નેચર ઇકોનોમિક્સ ડીલ વિથ ધી હાઉ ન્યુમરસ વોન્ટ્સ આર સેટિસ્ફાઈડ વિથ ધી હેલ્પ ઓફ લિમિટેડ રિસોર્સિસ સો જનરલી વોટ ડુ યુ મીન બાય ઇકોનોમિક્સ સો ઇકોનોમિક્સ ઇન વિચ economics provide guidance to the human being clear provide suggestion to the human being how human being can satisfy their unlimited needs and wants with the help of limited resources clear so there should be scarcity definition scarcity mean in which there should be unlimited needs and wants limited resources so there should be urgency of needs you have to decide urgency એટલે કે વિચ ટાઈપ ઓફ નીડ્સ એન્ડ વોન્ટ્સ યુ હેવ ટુ સેટિસ્ફાય ફર્સ્ટ એન્ડ વિચ ટાઈપ ઓફ નીડ્સ એન્ડ વોન્ટ્સ યુ હેવ ટુ સેટિસ્ફાય સેકન્ડ યુ હેવ ટુ ડિસાઇડ ધી પ્રાયોરિટી ક્લિયર તમારે પ્રાયોરિટી ડિસાઇડ કરવાની કે ક્યાં નીડ્સ એન્ડ વોન્ટ્સ તમારે પહેલા સેટિસ્ફાય કરવાની ક્યાં નીડ્સ એન્ડ વોન્ટ્સ પછી ક્લિયર પોસ્ટપોન યુ કેન પોસ્ટપોન ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ ફૂડ શેલ્ટર એન્ડ ક્લોથ યુ કેન નોટ પોસ્ટપોન ક્લિયર ફૂડ શેલ્ટર એન્ડ ક્લોથ ધેટ શુડ બી કન્સિડર એઝ બેઝિક નેસેસિટી ઓર પ્રાઇમરી નીડ્સ So you have to satisfy first your basic necessity. For example, BMW, OD, washing machine, air conditioner, આ બધી નીડ કેવી કહેવાય સેકન્ડરી. You can live without air conditioner. You can live without washing machine. You can live without BMW. But you cannot live without food. So first you have to satisfy your primary needs. Then you have to satisfy your luxurious needs. Clear? So it is the science of economics center on want, effort and satisfactions. So here is each and every human being have a unlimited needs and wants. So you have to make effort. Effort means you have to doing economic activity. So you have to satisfy your needs and wants. So your listen, this process is continuous. Clear? Why? Because your needs and wants are unlimited. For example, once you purchase bicycle, clear? Then your next need is to purchase the two-wheel. Once you purchase two-wheel, then your next need is four-wheel. Once you purchase four-wheel, then your next need is to purchase luxurious car. Clear? So economics not only cover the decision-making of behavior of individual, but also macro variable of economics. So generally, economics not only cover the micro problem, so macroeconomic problem. like national income problem, public finance, international trade and so on, like poverty problem, unemployment problem, inflationary situation, that should be also part of the economics, clear, macroeconomics. International trade means buying and selling activity taken place between two countries, export and import. What do you mean by export and what do you mean by import? Export means when you sell goods in foreign country. कोई पण वस्तु तमे foreign मा sell करो तेने शुं कहेवाय export. Import એટલે when you purchase goods, products from the foreign country. Foreign country पासे थी कोई पण वस्तु purchase करो तेने शुं कहेवाय import. Clear? So here is only meaning of economics. Clear? So several economics have defined economics taking different aspect into account. The word economics derived from the two Greek words, that is oikos means house and nemin to manage, means to manage the household activity, to manage the economical activity which is related with money, clear, which would mean managing the household using the limited funds available. So you have to manage, clear, how human being can household means human beings, clear, how you can manage, clear, with the help of limited funds. Limited funds એટલે limited resource. બધા resources, natural resource, financial resource, capital resource, human resource, આ બધા resources કેવા છે? Limited. તમારી પાસે money કેવા છે? Limited. તમારી પાસે land કેવી છે? Limited. Clear? તમારી પાસે, for example, labors, human, clear? Human resource, labor, worker, skillful labor, unskilled labor, human beings, clear? So human resources are limited, clear? So you have to manage in proper way, most satisfactory manner, clear? So you have to just, here today we complete only meaning of economics, clear? So you have to keep in mind there are two type of economical, clear? There are two type of economics, microeconomics and macroeconomics, divided into two parts, microeconomics and macroeconomics. Micro means which is related with only particular company. कोई पण problem आवे तो ये only one company ने जो affect कर से. Like salary problem, wages problem, bonus problem, if there will be a conflict, dispute between employer and employees, clear, if there will be a working condition problem. So आप बद्धा problem कोने affect करे? Only one company or one organization, one industry, clear. But if there will be a problem of GDP, per capita income, national income, poverty, clear, then unemployment, then here is export, import situation, clear, inflationary situation, આ બધા કેવા problem છે? Macro problem, which affect the whole country, whole India. For example, if there is a change in GDP, GDP માં change આવે તો કોને affect કરશે? Whole country. If there will be a change in national income, if there will be a change in per capita income, તો એ કોને affect કરશે? આખા ઇન્ડિયાને, clear? So it is a macro problem. So I again repeat, economics divided into two parts, that is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Macro means wider, micro means particular, which affect the only particular company or particular organization, clear? And macro means which affect the whole India. Then here is economics, only consider the economical activity. There are two type of activity, economical activity and non-economical activity. What do you mean by economical activity? Means to main objective is to earning a profit, clear? કોઈ પણ activity કરો એનો main objective earning નો હોય, income નો હોય, તેને શું કહેવાય? Economical activity, clear? And non-economic એટલે, for example, that type of activity in which main objective is to provide social welfare, social benefit, provide free of education to the poor people, free of medical care facility, health care free of facility, clear? And our main objective so is social welfare, clear? Charity. So to betterment of this society, non-economical activity. But economics only consider the economical activity. For example, when doctor provide treatment to their own son, clear, own daughter, to ene kevi keva se non-economical. Ken keno main objective shun che? Benefit, social welfare, clear. But here is when your main objective, when doctor provide treatment to the patients, clear, patient ne treatment aape doctor, eno main objective shun hoy? to earning a income, to earning a profit. So it will be part of the economical activity. When teacher, for example, teacher teach their own son or daughter, clear? Potana j son ne ke daughter ne study karave to, that would be considered as a non-economical. But if teacher teach to the student, clear? Student ne teach karave to, eno main objective shu hoy? To earning income. So it is the part of economical activity, clear? So I repeat, microeconomics and macroeconomics. Micro means it affects only individual firm, individual company or organization, and macro means wider concept, clear, which affect the whole country, India, clear? And economics, why there should be economic problem sa mate che, to ke each and every human being have a unlimited needs and wants, clear? Each and every human being have a unlimited needs and wants, but here is the resources are limited. Why there should be economic problem? So, ke tamari ichhao badhi kevi chhe? Unlimited needs and wants, clear? Jaruriyato kevi chhe? Unlimited. And resources keva chhe? Scarcity atle achat. Resources means financial resource, human resource, capital resource, natural resource, clear? Abadda resources keva chhe? Limited, clear? So there should be economic problem. For example, tamari paase unlimited money ho, to there should be no any kind of economic problem. You have a limited money, limited finance, so there should be economic problem. So economics suggests how human being can satisfy their unlimited needs and wants with the help of limited resources, clear? So this is the basic meaning or basic introduction of economic subject. From next lecture, we are going to start wealth definition. There are three definitions: wealth oriented definition, welfare oriented definition, and scarcity definition. So one by one definition with importance and limitation, we will start in next lecture, clear? So today we only complete the meaning or introduction of the economics. So if you have any doubts or query, then you can message me, clear? Thank you all.